Hey, what is up with you guys? Welcome back to House of Secure Network. Today we're going to talk about Zero Trust security on the cloud. Of course, many of you must be already aware of the Zero Trust architecture when it comes to on-premises, but when it comes to cloud, many things change. So let's get started right away. Now, there are a bunch of mistakes the architects make before implementing a Zero Trust framework in their environment is that they do not plan all the vulnerable entry points. These vulnerable entry points are perimeter security, that is the entry point from the internet facing devices in your infrastructure. Another key element to include in the plan is application security. This is an extra element that is required when we are building a cloud security Zero Trust framework. Of course, this can be excluded had this been just an on-premise infrastructure. A lot of today's applications reside on the cloud, be it on Azure or AWS or even Citrix or VMware platforms. This sort of environment increases the need to pump up the application layer. Next up is endpoint security and email security. These areas are essentially the bare minimum layers of security even on a cloud setup. Especially when the world is working from home these days due to the pandemic, and there are situations where the end users may be using their personal laptops for work. During these times, it is important to secure these communication channels because these are the low-hanging fruits for the cyber criminals out there. Alright, so the next question in my mind would be, where exactly do we start? So here's a simple process where, as an architect, you can start off with identifying the perimeter of your infrastructure, following mapping key resources of the traffic flow, be it inbound or outbound traffic. Once that is noted, it's time to put an implementation plan to execute those configuration steps to achieve a zero trust state of your infrastructure. In the end, it is always a best practice to govern and maintain the level of infrastructure throughout the year by conducting periodic audits, maybe quarterly or half yearly, you know, just so that your setup is up to date and ready to take on new attacks. With that said, let's look at how an ideal Zero Trust architecture may look like at a very high level. Considering a setup where the data center is partially on-premise and the other half is on the cloud, here's a recommended Zero Trust boundary designed for such a setup. In this sort of scenario, along with the users, the corporate devices, and the actual data, it is imperative that the cloud side of the infrastructure is also brought in the Zero Trust boundary. Now, just because these applications reside on Azure or AWS, it does not necessarily mean it has to be trusted by default. It has to be placed in the untrust zone too. Well, here you have now a simple Zero Trust cloud architecture, which of course you can play around with as per your organization's setup. Check out some of these Azure and AWS best practices that will help you define a Zero Trust model for your cloud setup. Until next time, keep watching the House of Secure Network. Goodbye.